Hi everyone, my name is Shazri and today I'll be talking to you about SEO, some of the techniques that you can use to improve your SEOs and some of the updates that are going around. Quick question, who did a Google search today? Anyone?
Yeah.
What did you search for?
Images. Balancing Man.
Balancing Man?
Yeah.
Anyone else? What did you search for?
VRN 360.
What's the site you went to? Do you remember? You clicked on a, you saw a site and you clicked on it. You got the information required? Search engine optimization is exactly that. It's a practice of increasing the quantity and quality of your traffic coming from organic searches. So you know that in search there are two types of ways you can bring in your audience. One is through advertising, that's search marketing, and the other one is organically, which is called search engine optimization. Yeah, so that's a best case of how SEO works. So one thing we need to remember is when we say SEO, first thing that comes to mind is Google, but that's not the case. You can do SEO for Google, Bing, Yahoo and many more. It's just that Google is the most popular, so we tend to focus on that. So there are about 250 plus methods to improve your SEO, but Google doesn't come out and say this is what you need to do. It's actually a group of experts that provide details through trial to let us know what works. So these are some of the key aspects of SEO that you need to do so you can improve your search rankings. So I'll just very briefly touch on some of these. Crawl accessibility is a methodology for the Google bots to actually find your site. I will go through in detail. Compelling content. So Arvind, you said you went to today's site and you found your answer. So that is a perfect example of compelling content. How do you provide the information that someone searching for actually finds it on your site? And Google actually ranks that as well. Relevancy, we call it. Yeah. So optimization. You search for VR. So that site is trying their best to optimize for the word VR in their search. Yeah. Then great user experience. This is your load time. Your UX, the experience in the site, even the safety aspects that Nilaksha spoke to about, that also plays a part in your SEO as well. Shareworthy content, these are others, how many other sites link to your site or share your content as well, that plays a part as well. Descriptions, the URL description, that URL I'm sure you all know what you all put right on the top, the sublinks beyond that as well. And snippets. I'll explain what this is later on as well. So one thing you need to know is when you search on Google, you're not searching the web. You're searching Google's index of the web. Yeah, so that's something we need. So technically the dark side of it is Google only shows what they want you to see. So that's the crazy part of stuff. So what Google does is there's something called indexing. They go to one site, see all the links that are on that site, they go to those links and see what are the links on those links. That's how they start indexing all the information that's available. Okay? So that's what you call indexing. There's something called robot text. So robot text is basically a map that we build on our site telling the Google spider, this is what you need to see on our site, this is what you shouldn't go to, and it pulls the information and provides it in your search results. Yeah? So just want to put the number. So what happens is when you put a search, Google starts going through its library of books, searching and picks out, let's say, about 100-200 search results. Yeah, and this is done in 0.3 seconds roughly, and it gives you the first page 10 answers or the second page or whatever pages in 0.5 seconds. So that's the speed that it does to provide you with information. So how does Google give you the right information? Because there's so much, right? There's about 200 results that they might get. So how does it categorize what's in the first 10, what's in the first 20 and so on? So these are some of the stuff that they look at. Overall, they look at the relevancy to your, basically if you're searching for VR, what's the relevancy in that particular site for VR related content. Based on that they rank. the rank based on the speed, if it's optimized for your mobile. Domain authority. So domain authority is how many, for example, how many other sites have linked to your site. That's a sign of credibility. Your page rank and so on. So SEO can be divided into two key areas. So on-site as well as off-page search. So on-site, of course, your user experience, your URL structure, your speed are key components of on-page development. Outside, it's about your link building, how many other people are using your site, connecting to your site for your content and so on. Even your social media activity and link back to your site also has a part on your SEO as well. So one thing again, I forgot to mention. So SEO can go across not only your links, it can also link to your images and videos as well. So just go through some SEO jargon. So this is a typical search page result, one particular aspect of it. So the first thing is what we call page title. Then it's the URL, then site links and more results. So you wouldn't believe it, there's a lot of thinking that goes behind these sentences, because every part of these sentences have an impact on your SEO. So that's why people like Anu and all take a lot of time to research what people are searching for. And then based on that, they develop content for this. There's a lot of work that goes behind a content writer for SEO. So this is the best example of something SEOing for your images. So this Dorito image, it's what you call an alt tag. You put a description for your image so that your image also can come up when you search for something. So when you do a Google search, in the top bar usually you get an image result. So that's thanks to stuff like this, with developing your alt tags. They say I want to be beyond number one. So that's the newest trend happening. So when they say beyond number one, it's usually they refer to something called schema markups. Usually this refers to searches like how do I change a car tire, how do I get a girlfriend. So this comes before, so this is a typical search result, but you realize it's coming above that. So this is a good example of schema markup. Technical point of view, this is what we need to do. I asked you also. So I doubt it, we have been doing something, so this is something that we also can try out. So this is whenever a client says I want to go beyond one, this is usually what they mean. Some case studies, I just want to type some stuff out for you while I wait. So one of the things that come to my mind in terms of SEO is some of the hotel guys. So booking.com, Agoda are some of the guys who have, and even TripAdvisor are really good in their SEO. So I've just booked, nothing to do with Agoda or TripAdvisor, I just put hotels in Sri Lanka. But look at what's coming up. TripAdvisor, let's say TripAdvisor because of the volume of content that's coming in. But then people like booking.com are continuously optimizing and researching as well. So booking.com, Jetprint is doing pretty well, and Agoda. Usually what they say is beyond this page is kind of like a cemetery, nobody goes to the second page. So the challenge is to get here. So this is the best example, not related to any of their brand names, but still why these guys are ranking. That's perfect example of good SEO. So I want to go to our own site. Decent, we are getting local search, we have obviously this is also been updated. Sublinks coming up, pretty decent. So for our brand name itself, it's coming up, but let me show you something that's under construction that we are trying to develop. So here there are certain issues that we need to solve. I don't think these are relevant. Momento trim, Momento sketch, those are something that is a work in progress right now for us. You understand, so how much of on-site, the amount of work that goes in for SEO. So these are some of the stuff I use, like robot.txt, where we tell the Google Spider not to follow these certain links and so on. So that's the amount of work that needs to go in on-site. What are the newest trends coming in SEO? Amazon is huge. So you wouldn't believe it, Amazon has surpassed Google in terms of product related searches, yeah, in the world. So these are amazing stats, but I think it's mainly in US and UK. So Amazon growing from 46 to 54% and Google declining from 54 to 46%. So the funny thing is, people who want to buy in Amazon go and search, yes. People who don't want to buy on Amazon, so go and first search the Amazon price and then go and buy it somewhere else. So that's the amount of power these guys have. So if you are selling a product, it's very good to start thinking about your SEO strategy on Amazon. Voice search, I'm sure you guys have come across this, is the next big thing. It's not next big thing, it's actually happening right now. So what they're predicting is 2020, 50% of your searches will be voice based. So that's half of this room here will be voice based searches. I don't do it right now, but I'm sure the trend will come where I'll start using it. So if you are wondering what's different in terms of SEO strategy, still speed, snippet plays a big part. But your localized search plays a bigger part. So best case scenarios is, hey Google, where's the closest pizza store? Hey Google, where's the closest laundry? So that's where our localized SEO comes into play. Basically, you go and listing your space on Google and so on, your address and so on. User behavior. We need to get into the minds of people who are searching. How will someone talk on Google or Alexa? Say, where is the closest pizza? Or get me a pizza. So that's the level of behavior analysis that you need for SEO on search. So that's the next level of research that's going on right there. Blockchain. So blockchain is where you remove the middle guy and transactions happen peer-to-peer. So in this circumstance, there won't be a Google. There won't be indexing. Yeah, so that will change the way SEO happens altogether. It's actually very complicated as well for me to explain. It's very complex. It's a new area. So Microsoft is championing this area. Obviously, they want to compete and they say this is the area to go for. In terms of advertisers, when you are using blockchain, you can no longer use bots and all. So whoever sees your ads according to blockchain is the actual person. You can't manipulate numbers or anything like that. There's no bots or whatever. It's the actual number, actual visitors that come through blockchain and SEO. Finally, GDPR. So GDPR is the General Data Protection Regulation. This was a regulation brought in by the European Union to protect the data of their citizens. There are a lot of regulations. One such regulation is you can't store data for more than 26 days. That's my understanding. So that's just one. So whenever your site is collecting data, there are certain regulations you need to follow. I'm sure when you go into a site, you have seen this site is collecting cookies. Is this okay with you? So that's the GDPR requirement. That's why they have put it there. So if your site is not according to GDPR regulations and you are dealing with European clients, very likely Google will downgrade your SEO ranking. That plays a part as well.